support system is checking out the health parameters of the launch vehicle and the spacecraft.
All sequences are
minus 45 seconds.
Minus 45 seconds.
Minus 40 seconds.
So we will have
minus 35 seconds.
We will have the ignition of L40 set minus 4.8 seconds.
Air stage is ready. Minus 30 seconds.
RS real time programs activated.
Minus 25 seconds.
All MOVs are opened.
Minus 20 seconds. Minus 15 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus
L40 4, ignition plus 5 nominal, S139 lift ignited, off, and vehicle lifts off from the launch pad.
Bilkul Saman, Prajwalan or vehicle ka prakshepan.
Tracking.
So vehicle liftoff normal and performance of L40s and S139 has been indicated as normal.
First stage performance normal.
Puri garjana ke saath zameen ke har ek kona aur vishal ka samudra ko alvida kehta hua GSLVF 08 apni us yatra par nikal pada hai jahan se use gantavya ke antim charan par भारतीय संचार उपग्रह GSLV-6A को अंतरिक्ष में प्रक्षेपित करना है. आप अपने स्क्रीन पर बाकायदा इसके गंतव्य पथ को देख पा रहे हैं.
So 52 seconds into the flight, the vehicle has crossed the atmospheric phase, which is a very critical phase. Right now it is
plus 1 minute,
11 kilometers. And as per the flight sequence, we will have the burnout of S139 stage at 110 seconds, when the vehicle would have reached an altitude of around 42.
SAR 1 in main auto.
So at 75 seconds, performance
SAR
2 is
in main auto.
Very normal in terms of time versus altitude first and time versus velocity. So after the S139 burnout, we will have the liquid strap-ons burning for the next 40 seconds. And after the L40 burns out, together the four liquid strap-ons and S139 will get separated at 151 seconds. So we are at 100 seconds exactly, altitude around 35 kilometers and a velocity of 1.5 kilometers.
S139 burned out normal.
So we just heard the announcement, S139 has burnt out at 109 seconds.
प्लस टू मिनट.
जी हाँ, जो कोर स्टेज थी S139 वो प्रक्षेपण से बर्न आउट हो चुकी है. इस समय एक स्क्रीन के आप जो देख पा रहे होंगे वो बाकायदा GSLV को अंतिम बिंदु की तरह आगे बढ़ते हुए. इस समय हम
फर्स्ट स्टेज परफॉर्मेंस
कुछ ही क्षणों में 150 सेकंड के आसपास द्वितीय चरण के इग्निशन का और प्रथम चरण के पृथककरण का क्षण देख सकेंगे.
So the
L40 engine shut off.
Yes, L40 engine has been
second
shut off.
Second stage ignited.
At 149 seconds, the second stage has been ignited, and the first stage separation successfully completed 152 seconds.
बड़ी ही महत्वपूर्ण घड़ियां होती हैं जब ये द्वितीय चरण ignite होता है या प्रज्वलित होता है. प्रथम चरण अलग होता है. इसी के साथ ही जो inter stage था वो भी अलग हो चुका है.
Second stage performance normal.
और द्वितीय चरण का जो निष्पादन है वो पूरी तरह से सामान्य.
वी जस्ट हर्ड द सेकंड स्टेज परफॉर्मेंस इज नॉर्मल. द फ्लाइट टाइम इज 185 सेकंड्स एंड द व्हीकल हैज रीच्ड एन ऑल्टीट्यूड ऑफ अराउंड 97 किलोमीटर्स. द नेक्स्ट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इवेंट दैट वी अवेट इज एट 225 सेकंड्स, व्हिच इज अराउंड 30 सेकंड्स फ्रॉम नाउ, व्हेन द व्हीकल वुड हैव रीच्ड एन ऑल्टीट्यूड ऑफ 115 किलोमीटर्स, व्हेन द हीट शील्ड और द पेलोड फेयरिंग सेपरेशन वुड हैपन. राइट नाउ हीट शील्ड इज protecting the spacecraft from the dense atmospheric phase. It has crossed from liftoff to the space. So 215 seconds, another 10 seconds to go before we have the view of the payload fairing separation.
जी हाँ, उसमें सुरक्षा कवच के अलग
अलग
payload fairing successfully separated at 226 seconds.
सफलतापूर्वक पेलोड फेयरिंग उसमें सुरक्षा अलग हो गई और इस समय उपग्रह जो है वातावरण से पूरी तरह से आमने सामने. आप अपने टीवी स्क्रीन पर जो ग्राफ देख पा रहे हैं उसमें क्षैतिज अक्ष x पर समय तथा ऊर्ध्वाधर अक्ष y पर ऊंचाई और वेग को प्रदर्शित किया गया है। यान के अनुमानित पथ को पहले अंकित कर उसकी तुलना अभिलिखित पथ से की जाती है। इसी तुलना को आप चमकते हुए बिंदु के रूप में देख पा रहे हैं जो हूबहू अनुमानित पथ को अनुकरण करते हुए अपने निर्दिष्ट पथ पर अग्रसर है। इस समय हम करीब करीब 4.4 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड की का वेग प्राप्त कर चुके हैं और इस समय 270 सेकंड समय व्यतीत कर चुके हैं।
सो राइट नाउ वी आर एट 275 सेकंड्स, द ऑल्टीट्यूड 131 and the relative velocity of around 4.9 kilometer per second. In the next
engine shut off.
Yes, we just heard the announcement GS2 has been shut off
and it has been separated.
It has been separated.
Yeah,
yes.
That's good news. GS2 dwiti charan jo hai wo alag ho chuka hai aur agla jo hai
5 minutes
first stage ignition confirmed
and cryogenic ignition stage has been ignited and it has been confirmed. And the event has happened at 298.7 seconds and the cryogenic ignition has been confirmed. The stage, the cryogenic stage is going to burn for the next 700 plus seconds before it imparts the orbital velocity to the satellite to the extent of around 10.2 kilometer per second, which is the inertial velocity. And this event,
stage performance normal.
This event should happen up to at 1066 seconds. Right now we are at 336 seconds into the flight. The altitude around 138 kilometers. And if you look at the downrange, the vehicle has crossed from the time it has lifted out from the launch base, it is nearly 900 kilometers from Shar now. And the vehicle has achieved a relative velocity of 5.13. Now if you look at the total velocity breakup, the first, second and the upper stage gives to the satellite before it goes into the geosynchronous transfer orbit. The cryogenic stage imparts almost 50% of the velocity to enable it to reach the final destined orbit of 170 km perigee and 36,000 km apogee. And right now we are at 380 seconds. The velocity is almost 5.2 and the vehicle is at an altitude of 140. Now if you look at the display plots of time versus altitude and time versus velocity, which is a plot on your screen, the plot of the pre-flight and the what is being achieved, a very very close match to both the parameters, which are basically the governing parameters for any launch, altitude and the velocity.
Cryo stage performance normal.
And very close match with respect to pre-flight and cryo stage performance normal.
जी हाँ, इस समय जो क्रायोजेनिक स्टेज है वो बहुत ही सामान्य निष्पादन देते हुए। दर्शकों, आपने कई बार सुना होगा कि हम स्वदेशी तकनीक से विकसित क्रायोजेनिक इंजन का उपयोग करते हैं। ये चरण इसलिए इतना जटिल और तकनीक रूप से महत्वपूर्ण है क्योंकि जिन द्रव गैसों का इस्तेमाल हम ईंधन के रूप में करते हैं उनका भंडारण, उनके नियंत्रित व सुनियोजित प्रवाह के लिए प्रयुक्त विधि व यंत्र, उनमें उपयोग में लाए गए पदार्थ और उनके गुणधर्म बेहद जटिल और गहन अध्ययन और अनवरत प्रायोगिक अनुभव चाहते हैं। हाइड्रोजन को -253 और ऑक्सीजन को -193 डिग्री सेल्सियस के तापक्रम पर संचित किया जाता है। अभी तक जो निष्पादन है वो बिल्कुल सामान्य। वर्तमान उड़ान में जो प्रयोग तीसरा चरण है सर्वाधिक महत्वपूर्ण है ये, क्योंकि बड़ी जटिल और उच्च तकनीक पर आधारित क्रायोजेनिक इंजन है। इसका विशिष्ट आवेग द्रव इंजन जो द्वितीय चरण था उसकी तुलना में लगभग डेढ़ गुना होता है और यही वजह है कि इसके उपयोग के प्राथमिकता की। इस समय हम लगभग 484 सेकंड का समय व्यतीत कर चुके हैं। दर्शकों, आपको बता दूं कि लगभग 1066 सेकंड के बाद हमें करीब करीब 9.745 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड का जो वेग है उसे प्राप्त करना है। तो अभी कुछ दूर है जब तक क्रायोजेनिक स्टेज का क्रायोजेनिक चरण का जो निष्पादन है वो अगर सामान्य बना रहा, सब कुछ सामान्य रहा, तो हम निश्चित रूप से इसकी सफलता की कामना कर पाएंगे। आप अपने स्क्रीन पे समय एमसीसी के अंदर बिखरे हुए जो उत्साह है उसको देख पा रहे हैं।
क्रायो स्टेज परफॉर्मेंस नॉर्मल।
सो द फ्लाइट टाइम इज 524 सेकेंड्स, altitude 136 and velocity of nearly 5.7 km per second. So we are halfway into the flight, the total flight time as Mr. Alok was mentioning is around
Plus 9 minutes.
1066 seconds, so we are roughly halfway around at 540 seconds right now. Just to make a quick mention of the performance of the cryogenic stage which Mr. Alok was mentioning, the cryogenic stage in this particular mission is going to impart almost 50% of the velocity to what the first and second stage imparts to this particular vehicle. The primary reason for this being the highest efficiency it provides in terms of the specific impulse compared to the solid and unstorable liquid propellants which are being used in the lower stage of the rocket now. Now if you look at the specific impulse, which is primarily a measure of the efficiency, which is achieved by a cryo, is of the order of 450 seconds compared to 3 seconds being provided by earth storable or maybe a solid fuels, which gives a quite a substantial payload advantage as far as the overall mission is concerned. In fact, what does it do really is when we have this kind of higher specific impulse for the upper stage, every 1 second improvement in the specific impulse adds up to something like 10 plus kilograms of the payload it can additionally carry in that particular mission, which we feel is quite a substantial advantage while we use the cryogenic stage. But as you may appreciate, every advantage will come with the associated technological complexity. As cryogenic propellants operate at extremely low temperature, it poses quite a substantial thermal and structural problems to the designers. And just to get a feel of the kind of temperatures it operates at extremely low temperatures. Just to give an update on the flight now at 640 seconds, the altitude is around 131. So quite a shallow trajectory, as you can, you'll be seeing in your screen very shortly. What you're seeing right now is the ground trace from the time the vehicle lifted off from Shahr. So on the way up to the last event.
11 minutes.
Yes, the very shallow trajectory, the altitude is 131 kilometers. But the
correspondent Rajesh Mantha phone line lo join avutunnaru. Rajesh, GSLV F8 prayogam manam chustunnam live lo enti eppudiki telustundi prayoganiki sambandhinchi
sodina ee satellite edaithe teesatundo idi vachesi dadapu 17 nimishala 46 second laku idini kuda subtraction avutadi idini subtraction ayin tarvata 24 gantala tarvata దీని యొక్క సేవలు అందుబాటులోకి వచ్చేటువంటి అవకాశం ఉంటుంది రోజున. అయితే ఇది కేవలం ప్రస్తుతానికైతే 2015లో పంపించినటువంటి ఒక రాకెట్ కి ప్రత్యామ్నాయంగా, ఎందుకంటే అది అప్పుడు దాంట్లో తలెత్తినటువంటి ఒక సాంకేతిక లోపం వలన అది కొంత పనిచేయకపోయేటువంటి పరిస్థితులు కనిపిస్తున్నందువలన శాస్త్రవేత్త దానికి ప్రత్యామ్నాయంగా వెంటనే ఇంకోటి ఏర్పాటు చేస్తే ఈ కమ్యూనికేషన్ రంగంలో ఒక ఉపయోగం ఉంటుందన్న ఉద్దేశంతోనే ఈ రోజు ఈ యొక్క జీశాట్ ఉపగ్రహాన్ని పంపించడం జరిగింది సోదిన.
రాజేష్, మెయిన్ గా కమ్యూనికేషన్ ఇంకా రక్షణలో కూడా దీని సేవలు వినియోగించుకోవచ్చు అని చెప్పి మనకు తెలుస్తోంది. ఇంకా ఏ డిపార్ట్మెంట్స్ లో జిఎస్ఎల్వి F8 సేవలు అందిస్తుంది?
ఇది ప్రస్తుతానికి మాత్రం, ఇది ప్రధానంగా ఇందాక చెప్పినట్టే ఇది 2015లో పంపించారు ఒక శాటిలైట్, దాని యొక్క సేవలు నిలిచిపోయేటువంటి ప్రమాదం ఉందన్న ఉద్దేశంతో దీన్ని ప్రత్యామ్నాయంగా ఉండడం కోసమే దీన్ని ప్రస్తుతానికి పంపిస్తున్నారు. అయితే ఇది ఒక విధంగా కమ్యూనికేషన్ వ్యవస్థతో పాటు తర్వాత భారత రక్షణ రంగానికి సంబంధించినటువంటి యొక్క సేవలు కూడా ఈ ఉపగ్రహానికి ఉంది. ఈ రెండింటికి సంబంధించి మాత్రం ఈ సేవల్ని స్పష్టంగా తీసుకునేందుకు మాత్రమే దీన్ని ఇస్రో శ్రీహరికోట అంతరిక్ష పరిశోధన కేంద్రం నుంచి కూడా ప్రయోగించడం జరిగింది సోజన.
రైట్ రాజేష్,
ద సెపరేషన్ సిస్టమ్స్ అబౌట్ ద from in the various stages.
Absolutely right. Like if you look at the kind of separations the GSLV employs in this particular manner, as you are aware, this is a three-stage vehicle. So in terms of the number of stage separation that happens when you compare with PSLV, it's very minimal here. We have only separation of first stage, which comprises of S-139 and L-40s also, and then the second stage.